हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम रूपना रविंद्रन, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ इंग्लिश, गवर्नमेंट डिग्री कॉलेज, चेवल्ला. टुडे लेट्स रीड द शॉर्ट स्टोरी अ विजिट ऑफ चैरिटी, रिटन बाय द अमेरिकन राइटर यूडोरा वेल्टी. यूडोरा वेल्टी वाज वन ऑफ द ग्रेटेस्ट लिटररी फिगर्स ऑफ द 20th सेंचुरी, अ वुमन राइटर बॉर्न इन 1909 एंड डाइड इन 2001. Her important works to mention are The Optimist Daughter and Death of a Traveling Salesman. So she has won a Pulitzer Prize in 1973 for her book The Optimist Daughter. Her works regularly appeared in magazines and also major periodicals. So her topic of concern includes the intricacies of human relationship, and she brings out this through her characters' interactions within the society. She is also an accomplished photographer. She has won numerous awards and accolades. She also received honorary degrees from Harvard, Yale, and Washington universities. So in this story, the author talks about a 14-year-old girl named Marian and her visit to the old age home, the old lady's home. Marian is a member of an organization in America called Campfire. So it's one of her duties of being involved in the organization that she has to visit an old lady's home. So from the story, we understand that she is a very casual human being and she doesn't care much for the elderly. In her carefree attitude, she just pays a visit to the old lady's home. She is reluctant to interact with the ladies over there. Let us read the story and then understand the rest of the things. It was a mid-morning, a very cold, bright day. Holding a potted plant before her, a girl of 14 jumped off the bus in front of the old lady's home on the outskirts of the town. She wore a red coat and her straight yellow hair was hanging down loose from the pointed white cap all the little girls were wearing that year. She stopped for a moment beside one of those prickly dark shrubs with which the city had beautified the home, and then proceeded slowly toward the building, which was of whitewashed brick and reflected the winter sunlight like a block of ice. As she walked vaguely up the steps, she shifted the small pot from hand to hand. Then she had to set it down and remove her mittens before she could open the heavy door. So the context is set. The character is 14-year-old girl Marian. So it's a very cold and bright day. So she jumps out of the bus. She jumps off the bus and then she moves towards the old lady's home, which looked like a block of ice that morning. So from the description of her physical appearance and all, we understand that she is a very casual young girl. I am a campfire girl. I have to pay a visit to an old lady. She told the nurse at the desk. This was a woman in a white uniform who looked as if she were cold. She had close-cut hair which stood up on the very top of her head, exactly like a sea wave. Marian, the little girl, did not tell her that this visit would give her a minimum of only 3 points in her score. So the receptionist, one of the nurses, is there to receive her. So she looks very stubborn, very rude. That is how the appearance is given. Then Marian is actually intended to come there for her 3 points in her score as part of her association with a campfire. But she doesn't reveal that with the nurse. Acquainted with any of our residents? Asked the nurse. She lifted one eyebrow and spoke like a man. So she looks very manly. She asks if Marianne knows any of the residents. With any old ladies? No, but that is, any of them will do. Marianne stammered. So Marianne is very casual. Any of the old ladies would do for her. She doesn't know any of them. So let me just go and interact with any of them. I'm not bothered about the emotional relationships and all that. I just want to talk to them and get my 3 points. That's it. With her free hand, she pushed her hair behind her ears, as she did when it was time to study science. The nurse shrugged and rose. You have a nice multi-flora scenario here, she remarked as she walked ahead down the hall of closed doors to pick out an old lady. So the nurse just raised her shoulders to show indifference, and then she just got up and then went with Marian. She was saying that you can find a variety of people here. That is what is meant by multi-flora scenario. So they are moving towards the inmates' room. There was loose, bulging linoleum on the floor. Marianne felt as if she were walking on the waves, but the nurse paid no attention to it. There was a smell in the hall like the interior of a clock. Everything was silent until, behind one of the doors, an old lady of some kind cleared her throat like a sheep bleating. This decided the nurse. Stopping in her tracks, she first extended her arm, bent her elbow, and leaned forward from the hips, all to examine the washed strap to her wrist. Then she gave a loud double rap on the door. So the nurse took her to one of the inmates' room, and then when they opened the door, they saw an old lady, and she just cleared her throat, and it appeared like a sheep bleating, because those people are very lonely in the old ladies' home. They don't interact with people, so they don't even speak. So in order to speak, she was just trying to clear her throat. There are two in each room, the nurse remarked over her shoulder. Two what? Asked Marian without thinking. The sound, like a sheep's bleating, almost made her turn around and run back. So the nurse told her that in each room there are two inmates. So even in this room there are two old ladies. You can speak to them. Then Marian was not listening properly, and then she asked, "Two what?" And she was scared of the sound, which appeared to her like the sheep's bleating, sheep sound. One old woman was pulling the door open in short, gradual jerks, and when she saw the nurse, a strained smile forced her old face dangerously awry. So one woman was trying to open the door. She looked very old, and she was opening it very slowly with jerks and all, shaky movements. And when she saw the no nurse, when the old woman saw the nurse, she smiled, but then it was not a proper smile. It was just like a made-up smile. Marianne, suddenly propelled by the strong, impatient arm of the nurse, saw next the side face of another woman, even older, who was lying flat in bed with a cap on and a counterpane drawn up to her chin. "Visitor," said the nurse. After one more show, she was off up the hall. The nurse just told the inmates that Marian is a visitor, and then she just escaped from there. Marian stood tongue-tied, both hands held the potted plant. So Marian had a potted plant with her. She brought it as a gift to the ladies. So she was holding the potted plant very tightly, and then she was not saying anything. The old woman, still with that terrible square smile, which was a smile of welcome stamped on her bony face, was waiting. Perhaps she said something. The old woman in bed said nothing at all, and she did not look around. So there are two old women in the room. One is there standing next to the door, and the other woman is lying on the bed. So the woman lying on the bed did not speak anything. The other woman was waiting for Marian to come inside the room. Suddenly, Marian saw a hand, quick as a bird claw, reach up in the air and plucked the white cap off her head. At the same time, another claw to march drew her all the way into the room. And the next moment, the door closed behind her. So Marian felt all this very strange. The first woman's hand looked like a bird's claw. She just snatched her hand and took her inside the room. My, said the old lady at her side. Marian stood enclosed by a bed, a washstand, and a chair. The tiny room had altogether too much furniture. Everything smelled wet, even the bare floor. She held on to the back of the chair, which was wicker, and felt soft and damp. Her heart beat more and more slowly. Her hands got colder and colder, and she could not hear whether the old women were saying anything or not. She could not see them clearly. How dark it was. The window shade was down and the only door was shut. Marian looked at the ceiling. It was like being caught in a robber's cave just before one was murdered. So all these looked very strange for her. The room was not neat at all. It was damp and there was a wet smell in the room. Then these women also looked very strange. Marian just observed the things in the room. The room was full of furniture. And when she looked at the ceiling, she felt like a person caught in a robber's cave just before being murdered. "Did you come to be our little girl for a while?" The first robber asked. Then something was snatched from Marian's hand, the little potted plant. So the woman who was a little active asked her, "Have you come here to be our little girl? Because we are very lonely here. Did you come to us to be with us for some time, to talk to us and be our little girl?" So she just snatched the potted plant from Marian's hand. "Flowers," screamed the old woman. She stood holding the pot in an undecided way. "Pretty flowers," she added. So Marian is not acquainted with these kinds of old people. She doesn't have any awareness about old ladies' home also. So she is not prepared and she feels very uncomfortable. Then the old woman in bed cleared her throat and spoke. "They are not pretty," she said, still without looking around, but very distinctly. Marian suddenly pitched against the chair and sat down in it. "Pretty flowers," the first woman insisted. "Pretty, pretty." So both of them started a kind of quarrel. One woman who's lying down on the bed is saying that it's not pretty flower, but the other woman is saying that it's pretty, pretty, very pretty. Marian wished she had the little pot back for just a moment. She had forgotten to look at the plant herself before giving it away. What did it look like? So Marian didn't even look at the flower properly. She just want to give the gift and get her points. That's it. Stink weeds, said the other woman sharply. She had a bunchy white forehead and red eyes like a sheep. Now she turned them toward Marian. The fogginess seemed to rise in her throat again, and she bleated, "Who are you?" So the old woman doesn't talk much. So her throat is all dry, and the fogginess seemed to rise again. So slowly she is asking Marian, "Who are you?" To her surprise, Marian could not remember her name. Marian is very much anxious, tensed, seeing the behavior of these old women. So she is not in a condition to remember her name also. "I am a campfire girl," she said finally. "Watch out for the germs," said the old woman, like a sheep, not addressing anyone. "One came out last month to see us," said the first old woman. "A sheep or a germ?" wondered Marian dreamily, holding on to the chair. "Did not," cried the other old woman. "Did so. Read to us out of the Bible and we enjoyed it," screamed the first. So they again started quarreling. One woman says that another girl also came in the same way and she read Bible for them, but the other lady is not ready to agree with her. "Who enjoyed it?" said the woman in bed. Her mouth was unexpectedly small and sorrowful like a pet's. "We enjoyed it," insisted the other. "You enjoyed it. I enjoyed it. We all enjoyed it," said Marian, without realizing that she had said a word. So Marian is not in her conscience. She just uttered, "We all enjoyed it," listening mechanically to the old women. The first old woman had just finished putting the potted plant high up on the top of the wardrobe, where it could hardly be seen from below. So the first old woman put the potted plant on top of the wardrobe, and now it cannot be seen properly. Marian wondered how she had ever succeeded in placing it there, how she could ever have reached so high. "She looks very old. Then how come she is able to put that on top of the wardrobe?" Marian just looks her in surprise. "She mustn't pay any attention to old Eddie," she now said to the little girl. "She's ailing today." So the first old woman starts talking to Marian, and then she says that you don't give any attention to the other old woman. She's not well today. "Will you shut your mouth?" said the woman in the bath. "I'm not. You are a story." "I can't say, but a minute, really I can't," said Marian suddenly. She looked down at the wet floor and thought that if she were sick in here, they would have to let her go. With much to do, the first old woman sat down in a rocking chair, still another piece of furniture, and began to rock. With the fingers on one hand, she touched a very dirty cameo pin on her chest. "What do you do at school?" she asked. So the first old woman sitting on a rocking chair, and she's rocking the chair, and she asked Marian, "What do you do at school?" "I don't know," said Marian. She tried to think, but she could not, because she is very much tensed. "Oh, but the flowers are beautiful," the woman whispered. She seemed to rock faster and faster. Marian did not see how anyone could rock so fast. "Ugly," said the other woman in the bed. "If we bring flowers," Marian began, then fell silent. She had almost said that if campfire girls brought flowers to the old lady's home, the visit would count one extra point. So that is the reason why she has brought flowers to the old ladies. And if they took a Bible with them on the bus and read it to the old ladies, it counted double. So intentionally she has brought flowers, and she has also brought a Bible also. But the old woman had not listened anyway. She was rocking and rocking and watching the other one, who watched back from the bed. "Poor Addie is ailing. She has to take medicine, see?" she said, pointing a horny finger at the row of bottles on the table and rocking so high that her black comfort shoes lifted off the floor like a little child's. I am no more sick than you are, said the woman in the bed. Oh, yes, you are. I just got more sense than you have, that's all, said the other old woman, nodding her head. So these two women just pass time quarreling with each other because they don't have any other work. They are left lonely. Nobody cares for them. Nobody comes to meet them. So their pastime is just quarreling among each other. That's only the contrary way she talks when you all come, said the first old lady with sudden intimacy. She stopped the rocker with a neat pat of her feet and leaned towards Maria. Her hand breezed over. It felt like a petunia leaf clinging and just a little sticky. So this first old woman was showing a little more attention to the girl. So her hand looked like a petunia leaf. Petunia is a flower with white, purple or red leaves, and her hand was a little moist. When I was a little girl like you, I went to school and all, said the old woman in the same intimate, menacing voice. Not here, another town. So she started recollecting her childhood, the first old woman, and she said to Marian that she also went to school in her childhood. Hush, said the sick woman. You never went to school. You never came and you never went. You never were anything, only here. You never were born. You don't know anything. Your head is empty. Your heart and hands and your old black purse are all empty. You showed it to me. So I can't believe that you went to school. I don't believe that you even had a childhood. So you don't have any money, your purse is empty, and you don't have any remembrances of your childhood. And yet you talk all the time until I think I'm losing my mind. So they are desperate. They are lost listening to each other's words. Who are you? You are a stranger. A perfect stranger. Don't you know you are a stranger? Is it possible that they have actually done a thing like this to anyone? Send them in a stranger to talk and rock and tell away her whole long rigmarole. The second old lady is just speaking on her own. How come you tell all these nonsense stories, long rambling stories? You cannot just cook up stories like that. Do they seriously suppose that I'll be able to keep it up day in and day out, night in and night out, living in the same room with this terrible old woman forever? So they have been living in the same room since long time. So they are not able to bear each other now because they don't go out. They don't interact with other people. So the only face that this old woman sees is that of the other old woman and vice versa. So they are just lost and they don't want to continue their lives in the same monotonous manner. Marian saw the old woman's eyes grow bright and turn towards her. This old woman was looking at her with despair and calculation in her face. Her small lips suddenly dropped apart and exposed a half circle of false teeth with tanned gums. Come here, I want to tell you something, she whispered. Come here. Marian was trembling. So Marian was even more scared as the first old lady called her, and her heart nearly stopped beating altogether for a moment. Now, Eddie, said the first old woman. That's not polite. Do you know what's really the matter with old Eddie today? She too looked at Marian, one of her eyelids dropped low. The matter? The child repeated stupidly. What's the matter with her? Why? She's mad because it's her birthday. So she is behaving strangely because it is her birthday today and she is left alone without her family, said the first old woman, beginning to rock again and giving a little crow as though she had answered her own riddle. It is not. Screamed the other old woman in bed. It is not my birthday. No one knows when that is but myself. And will you please be quiet and say nothing more, or I'll go straight out of my mind. So those people are so mentally not balanced. And if the other woman keeps on talking, this woman will surely lose her mind. She turned her eyes toward Marian again, and presently she said in the soft, warm, foggy voice, "When the worst comes to the worst, I ring this bell, and the nurse comes." One of her hands was drawn out from under the patched counterpane, a thin little hand with enormous black freckles, with a finger which would not hold still, pointed to a little bell on the table among the bottles. "How old are you?" Marian breathed. Now she could see the old woman in bed very closely and plainly and very abruptly from all sides, as in dreams. She wondered about her. She wondered for a moment, as though there was nothing else in the world to wonder about. It was the first time such a thing had happened to Marian. So Marian was not acquainted with this kind of incidents. "I won't tell," the old face on the pillow where Marian was bending over it slowly gathered and collapsed. So that old lady is so sad now, terribly sad. And then soft whimpers came out of that small open mouth. So the second old woman is crying now, very weakly. Marian's face drew very close. The yellow hair hung forward. She's crying. She turned the bright, burning face up to the first old woman. "That's Addie for you," the old woman said spitefully. Marian jumped up and moved toward the door. For the second time, the claw almost touched her hair, but it was not quick enough. The little girl put her cap on. So Marian is feeling very much uncomfortable, and she just want to escape from there. So when she just starts to escape from there, another claw pulls her in. "Well, it was a real visit," said the old woman, following Marian through the doorway and all the way out in the hall. The old woman accompanies her outside also, in the hall. Then from behind, she suddenly clutches the child with her sharp little fingers. "Oh, little girl, have you a penny to spare for an old woman that's not got anything of her own?" "We don't have anything in this world. Not a penny for candy, not a thing. Little girl, just a nickel, a penny." So this old woman is begging Marian for money. She is in such a pathetic situation. She doesn't have anything on her own. So she pleads Marian to give money. Marian pulled violently against the old hands for a moment before she was free. Then she ran down the hall without looking behind her and without looking at the nurse who was reading field and stream at her desk. So Marian just wanted to escape from there, and then she didn't even look at the nurse who was sitting there and reading a book. The nurse, after another triple motion to consult her wristwatch, asked automatically the question put to visitors in all institutions, "Won't you stay and have dinner with us?" Marian never replied. She is in no mood to talk. She pushed the heavy door open in the cold air and ran down the steps. Under the prickly shrub, she stooped and quickly, without being seen, retrieved a red apple she had hidden there. Her yellow hair under the white cap, her scarlet coat, her bare knees flashed in the sunlight, and as she ran to meet the big bus rocketing through the street, "Wait for me," she shouted, as though at an imperial command, the bus ground to a stop. So she just ran off from there, and she asked the bus to stop there, and then she jumped on and took a bite out of the apple. So Marian is in an uncomfortable state throughout the story. During her visit, she interacts with the old ladies very much reluctantly. She observes that they live in such a uncomfortable rooms, filthy rooms. Marian panics at the sight of the old woman's sadness. However, instead of consoling the ladies, she just runs away from the spot after sending a few minutes with them. So she is not compassionate. Instead of being considerate, Marian is only bothered about getting her extra points. This story depicts the selfish motives of young people. They have these kind of purposeful intention behind their acts of charity. So the apple can be looked upon as a symbol of selfishness. And then the ailing old lady was a pessimist. The author describes the room of the two old ladies as robber's cave. The room doesn't have any ventilation. And from the behavior of the nurse, it can be observed that she is very rude. She doesn't have any sympathy towards the old lady staying in the old lady's home. And she just acted like a salaried employee. And the story, A Visit of Charity, portrays how the meaning of charity has changed from caring for and helping others to trying to earn points or to keeping up their appearances and fame for oneself. So that's all for now. Thank you. Thank you for watching. I'll give the link of this PDF in the comment box. You can click on this link, visit the website where I have uploaded this PDF. There are a lot of other learning resources also available in my English language website. Make use of that and learn English. Thank you.